What's up, you guys? Nicola Maserati here. Today, I'm going to be teaching you how to remove a background and composite text or whatever you want behind your subject in After Effects using the Rotobrush 2.0. Traditional rotoscoping used animated masks to isolate an element within your clip, which can be super tedious and incredibly time consuming. The Rotobrush 2.0 uses artificial intelligence, Adobe Sensei, to track your subject's movement and can cut down on that frame by frame refinement, which again makes things a lot less tedious and a lot less time consuming. But before we get into it, let's run that intro. All right, guys, like I said, today we're going to be learning how to isolate and separate our subject from the background. From there, you can do pretty much whatever you want. You can add text, you can replace the background. Possibilities are limitless. But before we get into all that, if you guys enjoy this kind of content and you want to see more, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can be notified every single time I upload a new video. All right, let's just get into After Effects. All right, so we're in Adobe After Effects right now. I have my clip imported and I've created a composition from that. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut this down to around 4 seconds. So I'm just going to go here, hit N, right click, go trim comp to work area, and now we have all of this. So we're gonna be using the Rotobrush 2.0. So the first thing that you wanna do is double click the clip, so it opens up this as a layer. We have this 4 second clip that we created from our in and out points. We're then going to go to this little tool here. This is the Rotobrush tool. We click that, you'll see this little circle with a plus sign in the middle. Now, this is your brush. So if I just click and drag, it creates a little mask there. Now, if for some reason it's not big enough or it's too big, what you can do is hit Control or Command, you're on a Mac, and hold that down and then click and drag with your mouse to make the brush bigger or smaller. From there, all we need to do is just go through and select our subject. And there you have it, it's selected our subject. So now we can zoom in a little bit, hit spacebar for the move tool, and we can see that it hasn't gotten everything. So I'm just gonna draw a line just there. And the Rotobrush 2.0 does a really good job. One of the things I'm seeing here is that the blonde in his hair is kind of going in with the overexposed kind of background there. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna hold down Alt, and that's gonna erase this part or take this part away from what we're trying to do. And we're just gonna drag it across there. And we'll just do a little tad bit more. Luckily, this guy's hair isn't super crazy, but if for some reason you have somebody that kind of has like spiky hair, or you've got someone with curly hair that's kind of out like this, you wanna go in and you'd wanna use the Refine Edge tool. So to get to that, what you're gonna do is go back up to where your Rotobrush tool is. You're gonna click and you're gonna see that Refine Edge tool. Now you're gonna see it pop up here. Now it's turned from green, which is our Rotobrush tool, to blue, which is our Refine Edge tool. Again, you can make it a little bit bigger by holding Control or Command and dragging up or down. I'm just gonna make this a tad bit bigger. And I'm just gonna start to kind of draw around the top of his head, because he's got just a little bit of frillies there. And you can see what it's done. So the white is his hair, and the black is what we're not including within our mask. So I think that's done a pretty good job. So from there, to get Adobe Sensei and the artificial intelligence to do everything, you just need to hit spacebar and let it do its magic. All right, so there we go. It is done. So let's take a look. You can see the border around there. It looks pretty good to me. It got his hair and everything that we needed it to get. So I wanna show you guys a couple things down here as well. So we have this toggle alpha. So if we click that, it's gonna change the background to black and then our subject that we've selected to white. This is just gonna help you see your selection a little bit better. If we go and look at toggle alpha boundary, that is the boundary that we created with the Rotobrush, the purple. And then if you wanna see it on red, you see that? So now our background is on red, and we have our subject just there. And you can change the color here where it says 50%. You can just change it to whatever color you want. You can have it on black if you like. Right now, the opacity is at 50%. If I turn that all the way up, you can really see how refined the selection is. And you can always go in there and adjust that a little bit more. Now, if I unclick it, it just brings us to a transparent background. So depending on what you want to do from here, you can create a new background. Let's just say, for example, you want a white background behind him. So you're going to right click, you're going to go to new, and then you're going to go down to solid. Then you can change the solid to whatever you want. We'll do white. We'll click OK. And then we're going to make sure we drag that to the bottom. And we'll get out of this layer here. And we have our subject on a white background. It was that simple. So let's say, for example, you want to add some text behind your subject. The first thing you want to do is make sure your clip is selected and then hit Control or Command D. And you want to go to the bottom layer, the one that you duplicated, and you want to delete this Roto brush so we get our background back. You can see we still have the top clip is the one that was rotoed out. We have one with the background and one with just our subject isolated. We can also delete this white solid. From there, you can just right click, go to text, type whatever you want. I'm just gonna say at the park. And then you're gonna take your text layer and sandwich that in between the two clips. And that's gonna put it behind. So let's take a look at the finished product. And there you have it, folks. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you got something from it. If you did, make sure you subscribe, hit the like button, and I'd love to hear what you think of this in the comments. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video.